We have another problem from the series. From the series 1 plus c square cos 2 theta by 2 factorial plus c raised to 4 cos 4 theta divided by 4 factorial plus etc. Now you consider the series c is equal to c square cos 2 theta divided by 2 factorial plus c raised to 4 cos 4 theta 4 factorial. Then the corresponding series is sine series. The one thing that the thing you should remember is this can be converted into a hyperbolic function rather than the usual circular function sine and cos. Okay. So first you write the corresponding sine series. For the sine series we have c square sine 2 theta by 2 factorial plus c raised to 4 sine 4 theta by 4 factorial plus etc. Okay, so that is equal to what is from these two equations you can write what is c plus is 1 plus c square by 2 factorial times cos 2 theta plus I sine 2 theta plus c raised to 4 by 4 factorial times cos 4 theta plus I sine 4 theta plus etc. So this c plus is takes the form 1 plus c square by 2 factorial and this can be written as e raised to I 2 theta plus c raised to 4 by 4 factorial e raised to I 4 theta plus etc. So this is equal to 1 plus c times e raised to I theta whole square by factorial 2 plus c e raised to I theta whole raised to 4 by factorial 4 plus etc. Okay. We compare this with the hyperbolic function that will give cos h of y where y is equal to c e to the power I theta. Then using the formula in terms of exponential series, this can be written as e raised to y plus e raised to minus y divided by 2. Okay, so that is equal to e to the power, this y can be written as c times cos theta plus I sin theta. It's equal to c times cos theta plus I sin theta plus e to the power minus of c times cos theta plus I sin theta whole divided by 2. And now we simplify this expression. We separate this expression into real and imaginary parts. So this is equal to, I write this as e raised to c cos theta into e to the power I times c sin theta plus, we'll write this as e raised to minus c cos theta into e to the power this is minus c I times sin theta whole divided by 2. So this can be written as this is e to the power c cos theta and we'll write this as cos c sin theta plus I times sine c sine theta. So this is e raised to, this is of the form e raised to I alpha. So that is cos alpha plus I sine alpha. Instead of alpha we have c times sine theta. Okay? So instead of alpha we have c times sine theta here. Plus e to the power minus c cos theta. Again we replace this quantity by, this is of the form e to the power minus I alpha. Instead of alpha we have c sine theta. So that is cos c sine theta. Due to this minus sign, we have minus sign here. Minus I times sine c sine theta. All divided by, we have all divided by 2. When collecting the real parts, we can get, this is the real part here, and this is the real part here. So in both the terms, this cos of c sin theta is common. So I'll write it as c cos c sin theta times, here we have e to the power c cos theta, here we have e to the power minus c cos theta. So this is the real part here, divided by 2. Plus, for the imaginary part, we have I times, we have imaginary part from this, you can get e to the power, the sine of c sine theta is common. Then we have e to the power c cos theta. From this you can collect minus e to the power minus c cos theta divided by 2. This is our c plus is. This is our c plus is. So c is nothing but the real part, that is cos of c sin theta into e to the power c cos theta plus e to the power minus c cos theta all divided by 2. Or you can write this is equal to cos c sin theta, this is nothing but cos h of c cos theta. Okay, because this is e raised to y plus e raised to minus y by 2 form. So you can write it as cos h c cos theta.